Norm, so listen, Ben Carson and his $31,000 dining set, Steve and Luis Mnuchin, taking trips on government planes, Virginia Secretary David Shulkin using taxpayer money to fly his wife to Europe and accepted tickets to Wimbledon. The list goes on and on. And now you have the Interior Secretary Ryan Zinke apparently spent $139,000 on books in his office. What do you make of this behavior? On his doors, doors. I don't know why where books came from, on doors. But that would be a lot of money on books as well, but on
there
doors.
There would have to
office.
Be some, Don, they'd have to be some very
rare books.
It would
be my
books.
Book.
And they must be very rare doors for $139,000. Thanks for having me back. And look, yeah. I served in government, as did Congressman Jolly. I had a series of positions for 6 years. If somebody had spent $139,000 on doors in my office, I would have known about it. Zinke claims he didn't know about it. It's hard to believe, Don, because there's been a series of other allegations about excessive expenditures. He's under investigation by the IG for his travels, for planes, for going to political events, for meeting with donors. So, and if he didn't know about it, that's a problem too.
Well, let me ask you this. Can I ask you this, Norm?
In the pattern, it stinks.
Let me ask you this. So I don't know. I don't know what the office looks like. I don't know how many doors it was. I don't know. I don't know if they're, maybe they're reinforced doors for security. They're a lot. I don't know. But I mean, would that make a difference? He still said he didn't know about it.
Don,
maybe it's
it would.
Maybe it's an old building that requires, you know, special doors. I don't know.
Well, here's what they say. They say that he didn't know about it, and that it's a series of doors. It's an old building where they have to retrofit them, and that water was leaking in through these doors. Don, maybe that's true, but how many lies do we need to hear from the Trump administration before we start to question the explanations they offer? The president alone, who after all is the spender in chief, a quarter of his presidency at his golf courses, a third at his own properties. The president alone told 2,000 lies in the first year, so he sets the tone. I'm not believing it. I think the inspector general should look into the case of the very expensive doors.
David, are these Republican values?
Sure. No, of course not. And look, this may have happened before in incidents in past administrations, but that doesn't matter because it's happening right now under Donald Trump's administration. You mentioned several examples. Listen, we've got Interior under scrutiny. We have HHS with Tom Price's travel that we already saw the investigation of. We saw Carson at HUD. We see the VA, and we see Mnuchin at Treasury. Don, that is fully one-third of the president's cabinet in under a year and a half that's under investigation for financial scrutiny. This is a bunch of first-rate grifters. This is the Beverly Hillbillies Donald Trump edition without the innocence. Yeah. This is something that Donald Trump should be ashamed of, and Zinke knows better, and he is lying when he says he doesn't know about these doors.
I think it's important that we put the response up, and this is from the Department of Interior, okay, talking about these doors. It said the project was requested by career facilities and security officials at Interior as part of the decade-long modernization of the historic FDR-era building. The secretary was not aware of this contract, but agrees that it is a lot of money for demo, install materials, and labor. Between regulations that require historic preservation and outdated government procurement rules, the cost for everything from pencils to printing to doors is astronomical. This is a perfect example of why the secretary believes we need to reform procurement processes. I just thought that it's fair. In all fairness, we needed to put that up,
Don,
there because we don't know what the underlying issues are.
Don, if I may, and I served with several people in this administration, and in public office, once you're elected, you either realize you're replaceable or you believe you've been coordinated. Mm-hmm. And the reality is, with Ryan Zinke, we saw somebody come in and he insists on having a flag put over the building when he's in office or in the building. We've seen him misuse travel, and now we're seeing the doors. The reality is, even if there's a security reason to spend $140,000, there is not a wise taxpayer reason to do so. Yeah. Zinke is accepting that for his own ego.
You're saying there are too many examples with this. So, Health and Human Service Secretary Tom Price was forced to resign in September following reports that he spent $400,000 in taxpayer funds on private jets. Do you attribute any of this to the fact that the president is a billionaire and known for lavish living? Is the cabinet, you know, trying to keep up, you think, Norm?
Don, I don't think it's that. I think it's the president's example of exploiting government. breaking a four-decade-long bipartisan tradition of giving up his businesses. He's hanging on to them. He's raking in cash and benefits from foreign governments all over the world, expressly prohibited by the Emoluments Clause of the Constitution. He brought his son and daughter, his son-in-law and daughter into the government. They hang on to their businesses. So people see what he's doing and they say, well, he's getting rich off the presidency, he and his family. Why can't I live a little bit? Tone at the top, Don. It's the key to successful organizations, and a rotten tone at the top is the key to failed ones. And that's the kind of administration Trump is creating.
We hear so much. I've heard emoluments and divestments so much, and divesting emoluments, and nothing ever comes of it. It just keeps rolling on. David, the president filled his cabinet with many millionaires, even billionaires. He believes that these are the best and the smartest people. Do they need to think again about what public service is about, that they're actually serving the public and not themselves and lining their own pockets?
Sure. Look, and this also speaks to character, both of the president and of the people we put in office. And we can't overlook that. Some are plunderers. Some are doing this out of some sort of enlightened self-enrichment, if you will. But at the end of the day, this is a matter of character for our government officials. Look, members of Congress are allowed, in most cases, to purchase first-class tickets, but they don't because they feel a certain level of accountability. In this administration, there is no accountability. And to Norm's point, tone is set at the top. And so whether or not these individuals are representing the president in the right light or in the light that he believes is correct, they certainly aren't reflecting the values of most taxpayers across the country, and it's fair to judge them on that.
David, Norm, thank you.
Thanks, Don.
$139,000 on books. Man, that's a lot of books. Must be good reading. I know it's a door. That was a joke. The producers are like, door. Thank you, guys.